darlings, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a fashion video. Ever since my last lookbook, I believe it was a summer splash. So why do I always want to say splash? In that video, I said splash like 3 times and I got corrected a lot by you guys. A summer slash spring video. Let me start that over. I lost my train of thought. Okay, ever since my last lookbook video, which is a summer slash spring look, I can't. It was a summer spring of fashion lookbook video and a lot of you guys requested for me to do more fashion videos. I know I used to do a lot more back in the day and I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, the reason that I don't do a lot of fashion videos is because I personally believe that because I'm not only a creator, I like to watch YouTube videos too. And if I'm watching a fashion haul, I wanna see the items tried on. I feel like it's a little bit boring to just see items like held up. That's cool and everything. Other people do that on their channel, but I like to actually show you guys everything on the body, like try on style. And I kind of put those videos off because they are a pain in the butt to film because it's just not a very easy task to try on 20 pieces of clothing in a row. And I like to normally film them outside and it's hot and there's a lot of distractions and everything like that. So I'm not gonna lie, I normally put them off, but I know a lot of you guys have been requesting for me to do a lot more fashion videos. So I'm trying my absolute hardest. And I think I'm doing pretty good. So these are the items that I'm gonna be showing you guys today. And they're actually all from AMI Clubwear. I'm gonna say that this is more like a summer haul. Pretty much everything here is like a lot of dresses. I have some bathing suits, a pair of shoes, some crop tops, a pair of pants. So I'm just going to jump into it. And again, I'm going to try on every single piece that I'm going to be showing you guys today. I just finished like an entire box of Cheez-Its all by myself. So I'm so sorry if you see like remnants of that in my teeth. Anyway, the first items that I'm gonna show you guys are 2 dresses and I really want you guys to help me pick out which one to wear for the 4th of July. I really can't decide. I'm leaning more towards one than the other, but I wanna see which one you guys think. So this is the first dress. It has these stars on one side and stripes on the other side. I guess it's supposed to resemble a flag. And I guess this is what you consider a midi dress. It's not all the way long to the floor, but it's definitely not a short dress either. And I love the cotton material because it's very light and airy and breezy. And I feel like this is very patriotic. I could definitely see myself wearing this on the 4th of July. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys. I did pick this up just thinking that that's the only day that I'm going to wear it on the 4th of July because I don't know, it seems a little bit out there with this whole flag look. But now that I look at it in person, I feel like I would actually wear this on a normal day. And my boyfriend is really into stars and stripes. I don't know why, it's like a sick obsession. And I am that corny girlfriend that loves to match my boyfriend. So I feel like whenever he pulls those shirts out, I'm gonna pull this baby out. So that is the first option for the 4th of July. Let me know if you like that one or this one better. And the next one is a 2-piece set. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, I'm not too fond of the top because it is a spaghetti strap and I don't really like the way that spaghetti straps look on me. So the top is just a very basic bandeau with spaghetti straps, but the bottom is this skirt. It has a ruching material on the side, so it's very, very flattering. A lot of you guys know that I say I don't really have too much of a booty, kind of lacking in that department, so I feel like this really emphasizes and, you know, helps work with what you got. I really love the stripes, and I think I would either wear this with a red top or a white top and maybe red heels, or maybe leave the red out altogether and just do the blue and the white. But I definitely feel like I would wear a pop of red lips if I didn't do anything red. But anyway, let me know what you guys think about 4th of July outfit. Which one? Oh, this is not the other one. This is it. Let me know which one that you would say, A or B. Next, I have been on the hunt for the perfect pair of white pants, and this is a style that I actually really like. It's high-waisted, but it has these buttons that go up, and it's a very stretchy material. White pants are actually extremely hard to pull off, and I do have another pair that's kind of like a denim material, so I don't really wear them too much during the summertime, but then I feel like when else are you gonna wear white pants? So I wanted to pick up a light pair that was not heavy, that I was not gonna sweat in, and I definitely wanted to find a pair that was high waisted. So I really like these. They're very comfortable. I can picture wearing these with a lot of different shirts, especially crop tops, and crop tops are actually what I'm going to be showing you guys next. I personally have a sick obsession with crop tops and I have 3 of them to show you guys. I normally, like, my uniform for the entire winter or the entire summer long is dresses. A lot of maxi skirts and dresses, sundresses, but lately I have just been wanting to wear a crop top every single day. So I did pick up 3. This is the first one. I think that the pattern is so, so cute. I love the Aztec kind of detail that it has going on. And I don't know how the camera is picking it up, but it's a pinky coral red color. I really don't have a lot of articles of clothing in this color. So I was like, yes, I want to pick that one up. And then I got two crop tops that are actually the same exact cut, just two different colors. I do not have any shirts in this color. Blue was one of those colors that I thought that I just couldn't really pull off too well. I don't know why I've never really thought that I looked good in blue, but I really like the way that it looked online. So I wanna try and make that work. And now I'm like realizing that this is very like 4th of July. Everything is red, white, and blue. I swear I did not do that on purpose. And this is the same shirt. This is just in red. I love red. That's one of my like go-to colors. So I love that. And next I wanna show you guys kind of like a jumpsuit. Here's the thing, I've always been really into rompers, and I think rompers are just when it's a whatever top connected to shorts. I don't know if it's called a jumpsuit when it's not shorts and a romper when it is shorts. That's what I think. So this is the first one that I actually own that does not have shorts connected to it, but it has pants. I love the material. I have a lot of dresses and tops and pants that have a similar pattern to this. I think I said material, I meant to say pattern. It's just kind of like a black and white. It ties at the waist, and then it has these pants that go all the way down to the ankle. And I love items like this because they're so easy. You basically don't need anything else. This is your entire outfit. Dress it up with a nice pair of sandals and some jewelry and you are good to go. And it's a very light, airy, breezy cotton material, which pretty much everything that I showed you guys is very light and airy. So I love that. And next I have two dresses to show you guys. I have one casual one and one dressy one. I'm gonna show you guys the casual one first. This is again something that's so easy to throw on. It has a beautiful floral print. I know a lot of people are kind of like, it's 50-50 on floral prints. Some people think that they're really granny-like. I personally love floral, especially during the summer and springtime. And I love the colors in this one. It's again a cotton dress. It's stretchy. I got everything in a size medium, by the way. And I think that I could have gone with a size small. This is one of the first times that I was trying out the brand. So that's why I did try a medium. But I do think that I should have gone with a small. And the next dress, this is so cute. This is definitely for going out for like a summer night, maybe for a drink or something. I love like this detail right here. I don't even know how to describe it. I'm just gonna hold it up so you guys can look at it. It's kind of like a cutout right there, little gems at the, why am I forgetting that word? The neckline, I kind of wanna say. And you guys know that I love nude everything, so it's a nude dress. Very fitted, very cute for summertime. I feel like it's sexy and flirty and playful all at the same time. So I really do like this dress a lot. I can't wait to find a place that I can actually wear it to. And the two last things that I have here is a bathing suit and a pair of shoes. This bathing suit, oh my God, you guys. I don't know why I wasn't expecting like that much from it. It's a very, very well-made bathing suit. Obviously, I'm not gonna try this on because that would be a little bit weird. But when I tell you guys that the quality is like the quality of Victoria's Secret bathing suits. It's very like stiff, it's not flimsy and something that's just gonna fall off of you when you get in the water. And I have always wanted a white bathing suit. I don't know why, I never had one and I always wanted one. I love the cups, they are molded and they have padding in them. So it's gonna help you or help me a little bit in that area. And it's not gonna, you know, have any indecent exposure when you get cold, if you know what I'm saying. And I really like the detail on the waist over here. I think that's really cute. I really like wearing one pieces, but I don't like to, you know, feel like an old lady. I wanna show a little bit of skin, but I'm not 100% comfortable in a bikini. So this is like right in between. And it looks kind of weird now that I'm holding it up. It looks saggy, but obviously when you're in it, that fills out and you just see kind of those lines on the side. I am the worst person ever at describing items. I don't even know why I try half the time. And last but not least, these shoes, you guys. Oh my God, these are so freaking gorgeous. I got these because I have two weddings coming up this month. Two of my best friends are getting married and they both want me to wear nude shoes. So when I saw these, I was like, oh my God, these are gorgeous. I can definitely re-wear them. They're not only like wedding type shoes. And these are $29. Yes, yes, yes. And that is everything that I wanted to share with you guys for this try on clothing haul. If you like these videos, make sure to give it a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below letting me know. Thank you guys so much for watching and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.